Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Ron from Australia sent in this question. He's actually talking about episode 1004. He says, wait a second. When I try to build an area chart with certain items blank or NA, it doesn't seem to be working. And I said, oh, Rod, I know that this works because I wrote about it in my charting book. And I went back and sure enough, figure 3.34 shows how this works. So here, I'm in Excel 2003 temporarily. I'm going to do this exact same trick that the book talks about, where I choose Series 2 and change the chart type to an area chart. And look at that. Look how it takes from May 0 and then draws up to the June, completely the wrong effect. Let me show you how cool this looks in Excel 2007. And so, unfortunately, the answer for Rod is going to be, well, it just doesn't work in Excel 2003, but it does work in Excel 2007. I'm going to build a line chart first, and we'll build a 3D line. And you see that there's something unusual here. There's highway construction in June, July, and August. So, I want to highlight that section of the chart. So, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to get rid of that legend. And then here for June, July, and August, I want to build a formula that pulls that value over. So, just those 3 months. And then I choose the chart, grab the blue outline to extend the data that's on the chart, and I get a second series. And what you see initially happens is that just that section is highlighted in red, but I want to choose that series. So, I come here to the Layout tab and choose Series 2, and then change the chart type for that series. I'm going to change it back to the first area chart. So, I'll scroll down to area, choose that. Click OK. Now, look at that. It's beautiful here in 2007. It draws straight vertical lines, which allows us to highlight that section of the line. Now, for this particular case, that red seems just a little bit too dramatic for me, so I'm going to go into Shape Fill. But of course, I have to select Series 2 before I do that. Shape Fill, choose a nice light gray, maybe right there. All right, good. So now we've highlighted that section of the chart. And then, of course, to finish this out, we want to add a nice title. So, chart title above chart, sales by month, and I'll press enter. All right, now let's come back in and edit this. We'll press enter to go to a new line and say highway construction in the summer hurt sales. And this is pretty cool. I'm going to choose just those characters and go back to the Home tab, change the font size of those characters, basically creating a subtitle. I want to make that whole thing left justified. And so now we have a nice title and subtitle on the chart with those items in the subtitle, the summer months, being called out by a second series. Now, as Rod pointed out, this does not work well in Excel 2003. When we have an area chart and it goes from nothing to a number, they draw the diagonal lines in, does not look as good at all. So, there you have it. Something for those of you who have upgraded to Excel 2007. Great way to highlight one section of a line chart. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.